Good evening, sir. Sir, my question...
Mike is right.
My question is not exactly related to economics because I'm an engineering student.
Sure. I was also an engineering student once more a time.
So, sir, actually I wanted to ask that, whole world knows that Indians are innovators, but India is not innovating. In a sense, if you will see an innovation index, India is not even in top 50, and country like Switzerland and cities like Zurich and Geneva, whose population is equivalent to number of engineers we are producing, they are at the top list. So don't you think that, and India is going just opposite to European countries like MHRD, our government is reducing the subsidy on the technological institutes. Like just now news was there, maybe you are aware that they are making all the NITs, I am from National Institute of Technology, they are saying that these colleges should be self-funded because people are taking subsidy and they are not staying in India and they are going outside. So don't you think that the lack of subsidy and opportunities in the research areas, like after I am completed my engineering, I don't have much money in the research. So is this affecting our economy because we are not innovating? We are just manufacturing the technology which we import from the foreign.
Right. I mean, yours is a very deep question. I don't think I fully agree with the Indians are more innovative. I think we've shown that Indians who go abroad, the selected sample that go abroad, can achieve a great deal of success. And I believe some of them are in this room. But they're a selected sample. Broadly, if you look at our population, we have 1.2 billion people. If we just met what was demanded by 1.2 billion, we'd have 1 in 6 Nobel Prizes. We'd have 1 in 6 CEOs. We're very happy when there are 3 CEOs across the world who are, 5 in tech companies who are Indian, and we say, look, we are so innovative. But given how many Indians we are, we should have plenty more. So even if we are normal, we're not especially brainy, but we're normal people, we should bat 1 in 6 on everything in the world. 1 in 6 gold medals at the Olympics, 1 in 6 Nobel Prizes, 1 in 6 great books. I mean, you get my point. The question is, how can we achieve our potential? Forget going beyond it. How can we get up to our potential? And in terms of training engineers, it's not so much the quantity we train, because the same engineers we trained here go abroad and get do fantastic innovation. So it's more about the system, whether it encourages innovation once somebody leaves college. And there I think things are changing. I think when you look at this whole bevy of startups that we see here in Bengaluru, elsewhere, young people increasingly don't want to go work for McKinsey. They want to go start their own thing. And they're enthusiastic about it, they work very hard on it, and they have all sorts of crazy ideas, some of which fail, or many of which fail, but some of which succeed. So my sense is the environment for entrepreneurship, the environment for innovation is changing. As global competition comes to India, the need for our firms to compete at a global level is also increasing. And so undoubtedly, they will look more for innovation for engineers from here. As you know, many firms from abroad have set up in Bangalore and Hyderabad research labs because they want to tap into that same innovation. So I think the need is to broaden this, perhaps more than subsidizing more engineering.
Sir, one second more. Sir, in Europe, the education... Okay.